This video lecture addresses the electromagnetic spectrum. Slides are based in large part on materials taken directly from the text by Campbell and Wynn, 2011. As Campbell and Wynn, 2011, page 31 note, quote, "Interpretation of remote sensing imagery depends on a sound understanding of electromagnetic radiation and its interactions with surfaces and the atmosphere." In general, we recognize that all objects emit electromagnetic radiation except those at absolute zero. Electromagnetic radiation is generated by several mechanisms, such as changes in the energy level of electrons, an acceleration of electrical charges, the decay of radioactive substances, or the thermal motion of atoms and molecules, Campbell and Wynn, 2011. The major source of radiation entering Earth's atmosphere is from the Sun, and this energy comes from nuclear reactions within the Sun that produce a full range of electromagnetic radiation. As the radiation approaches Earth, it has been transmitted through space without major changes. Radiation travels through Earth's atmosphere to the surface of the planet. Radiation from the Sun is the source for two of the three major types of remote sensing images. First, radiation from the Sun is reflected upward, which forms the basis for photographs and similar imagery. In this image from the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, 2011, note the energy reflected by the atmosphere, clouds, and surfaces. Second, radiation from the Sun is absorbed at the surface of the Earth. This absorbed radiation is then re-radiated as thermal energy, which can be used in remotely sensed images. A third type of remote sensing includes man-made radiation, for example, radars, that can be used to generate remote sensing imagery. This image depicts a concept diagram of active phased array radar technology being developed by Australia and the U.S., Defense Industry Daily, 2014. The radar sends out pulses of energy, and the returns are recorded and transformed into a remotely sensed image. This is an example of active remote sensing. Electromagnetic radiation travels at the speed of light and is characterized by three key properties: wavelength, frequency, and amplitude. The wavelength is the distance from one wave crest to the next, and can be reported in common units like centimeters or micrometers. Frequency is measured as the number of crests passing a fixed point in a given time period, and is typically reported in hertz. Amplitude describes the height of each peak. As Campbell and Wynn, 2011, page 31 note, quote, "Electromagnetic radiation consists of an electrical field that varies in magnitude in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Similarly, the magnetic field varies in magnitude in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation in a plane oriented at a right angle to the electrical field." As Campbell and Wynn, 2011 note, there are no distinct, clear, or sharp breaks in the electromagnetic spectrum, but we have established subdivisions for our own convenience and understanding. In remote sensing, we are most concerned with the reflective spectrum, which extends from approximately 0.38 to 3.0 micrometers. The reflective spectrum is defined as the, quote, "portion of the solar spectrum used directly for remote sensing," Campbell and Wynn, 2011, page 34. Regarding the major divisions of the electromagnetic spectrum, as shown here, the longest wavelengths, that is, the radio waves, are shown on the left, and the shortest wavelengths, that is, the gamma rays, are shown on the right. The pictures below suggest sources of energy along the electromagnetic spectrum. These principal divisions help us in understanding remote sensing technology and capabilities. Gamma rays have wavelengths less than 0.03 nanometers and X-rays have wavelengths between 0.03 and 300 nanometers. Ultraviolet radiation, visible light, and some infrared wavelengths make up what is known as the optical spectrum, with wavelengths ranging between 0.30 to 15 micrometers. These are the wavelengths that can be reflected and refracted with lenses and mirrors. Included in the optical spectrum is ultraviolet radiation with wavelength limits of 0.3 to 0.38 micrometers, visible light with wavelength limits of 0.38 to 0.72 micrometers, near infrared with wavelength limits of 0.72 to 1.3 micrometers, mid-infrared with wavelength limits of 1.30 to 3.00 micrometers, and portions of far infrared with wavelength limits of 7.0 to 1,000 micrometers. Note that 1,000 micrometers is equal to 1 millimeter. Because the ultraviolet spectrum is easily scattered by Earth's atmosphere, this portion of the spectrum is not generally used for remote sensing of Earth materials. The two major divisions of the electromagnetic spectrum with the longest wavelength limits are microwave radiation with wavelength limits of 1 millimeter to 30 centimeters and radio with wavelengths greater than 30 centimeters. The visible spectrum with wavelength limits of 0.38 to 0.72 micrometers is defined by the sensitivity of the human visual system, in which the color of an object is defined by the color of light it reflects. Additive primaries are defined as blue, 0.4 to 0.5 micrometers, green, 0.5 to 0.6 micrometers, and red, 0.6 to 0.7 micrometers. No single primary can be formed by the combination of the other two, and all other colors can be formed by mixing the three primaries in the right proportions. Equal proportions of the three combine to form white light. Campbell and Wynn, 2011. In contrast, subtractive primaries are defined as the color of pigments and dyes. Each one absorbs a third of the visible spectrum, and in equal proportion, the mixture yields black, which is the complete absorption of the visible spectrum. The following references were consulted in developing this video lecture.